Good morning, everybody. I'm gonna try something new, something different. I got this 75mm scale Ellie from The Last of Us printed on my old Saturn II. I say old Saturn II because we've got a new printer in the studio, and hope to be doing the next project on that. So, something new, in many ways. Big fan of Ground Affected. He does things different style to me, which is acceptable. He's a good character, and he's done some good comments on my stuff. So I'm going to paint Ellie the way that Brent from Ground Affected. Or is it Brett from Ground Affected? Yeah, so Ground Affected. So what he's done is purple base colour. So this is Vallejo purple. And before we start putting paint onto this thing, I do have a coffee, as always. And my coffee machine's broken down, which is a disaster. So if anybody wants to donate the coffee machine to me, that'd be great. And maybe a packet of bourbons, which would be good. Okay, I haven't got my glasses on. I don't think I need them. So, flesh. Done the way. Same way as Ground Affected. So, just purple. Watered down. And everywhere. So I've got a nice big, nice long brush to do this. It's a totally different brush to the bigger models. This is a number one Winsor Newton Series 7. Again, in absolutely everywhere. Caring not a jot. And we'll do some detail work a bit later. At the moment, we're going to be colour blocking. I hope my mic's loud enough. Something that was picked up on my last video, or my last videos. I will try, but most of my painting is done on Saturday morning while everyone's asleep. It's a bit hard to be at a vocal level without waking people up. Luckily enough, this is ABS resin and is a bit more resilient. Okay, I'm gonna let this one dry, and then we'll get onto stage two. Now that the purple has dried sufficiently, we're gonna go put the first flesh colour on, which is a medium flesh colour by Vallejo. I hope I'm talking loud enough. Right, so a bit of water with that. We're going to make it a wash, but not too runny down, too Yeah, let's get a consistency a bit like that. Okay. And this is gonna go same as before. Slapping it all on at the moment, and we can get our brush and smooth it out if we need to. That's where it's heavy, take it out, I think. Raining outside again today. You would have thought that's England for you. And I'm going to leave that to dry. Come back to her a bit later. This is Ellie. After a couple of coats of medium flesh tone, I want to mix in a bit of basic skin tone to the basic flesh space. Basic skin tone into the medium flesh tone. Why they have to be flesh tone and skin tone, I do not know, but that's what I've got to work with today. Okay, so a bit of that and a bit of that makes it a little bit lighter. Now, put that down for a bit. We have got a small dry brush, which I'm gonna just hit across top there, across the nose, cheeks, and ears. Is it leaving definition? Yeah. Even different definition. So let's carry on. A bit more. I have a limited amount of paint on the palette, so I need to work kind of quickly and turn it over. Back of the neck, which like that. Okay, so a bit more paint on the brush, and we're going to do top of her arm like this, down, hit down. I've done this in a previous video. Light comes from the top, so if you hit downwards, you hit the top of every part of our arm. And it should miss. the muscle definition. A bit like that. Okay. I'm going completely off camera again. So we're at on this arm here. Let's get in a bit. Okay, so this arm here, this is patchy. So we get our brush and we go like this, and hopefully it'll cover the areas. Patchy areas. Like that. So a little bit more paint. You know, one drop of medium flesh tone, skin tone, flesh tone, and a bit more of the lighter skin tone, like that, which is definitely lighter than that. So we got our dry brush again, fill it up. Try and highlight some of the features like that. Okay. So that's our head done, chest done. So I just need to get from there and keep the same brush, and I got basic skin tone, and let's just make a judgment. We got some light up there, across there, tip of her nose, chin, cheek. Okay, so very delicately doing that. There's a tiny little bit of area there, which is more prominent on her shoulder, the very top, like elbow, and a tiny little bit there, and a tiny little bit there. Forearm, across there, thumb, finger, thumb, forearm, and it's the noisy biker. Thanks a lot. So this shoulder. Across the top. Oh, just a little bit. Just a little bit. need to put some in there. So I'm just going to roll. Okay. Clean that up. Awesome. Clean up, brush out. As always, I've got this fantastic Agrax earth shade. Just put that there. So if I work on that purple mark there, I know where I'm painting. Okay, Agrax earth shade. With Agrax earth shade, you need a brush of certain size. And I think it might be this one. This is number six. Number six. This is from Jackson's, which is literally a 5-minute walk from my house. So this Agrax Earthshade is very watered down. This is Ellie. She's got a bit of dirt on her. We can wipe certain areas off. Think it's too much, just take a bit away. I'm happy with that result. And leave it for a little bit. Come back and do some touching up. This is Ellie so far. I've redone her face because I basically didn't like it. I could do better. So a bit of IPA, took it back to the resin. Then a bit of primer, black primer, and start again. Just as we did before. So she's looking a lot better now. I'm not happy with the consistency of the paint I'm using. It still seems to be a bit chalky. So I'll move on. It's been washed, and I'll outline for the top half of her shoulders, backpack, And don't. So what I'm going to use is dark gray. And nice pointy brush from Artist Opus, a bit of water, and get it quite thin. And we need to get into areas like down here. And just let the point go into the crease. Noisy neighbors, as always. If you do go over the flesh, just clean your brush out. Go back with a bit of water and push it back. Let gravity help you. Clean up a little bit with a less pointier brush. That one there. Which is absolutely filthy. So I'm not use that one. And brush it away. Again. If this noise carries on, I'm gonna have to stop. But it's gonna get worse when the kids kick out of school. And the backpack is exactly the same as move the light that we're looking at. And just dark grey pretty much everywhere. Now there's a couple of badges on the back of here, and I think my son has exactly the same badges. I will go and research. Okay, so base color on there, the vest is going to be a bit lighter, the rucksack is going to be a bit bluer, the bottom of the rucksack is going to be brown, a livery brown. I think but we can leave it like that for a moment and to get back to it when it's dry. Okay, so the gun and the clip. Yeah, we're going to do that in the same colour. So in grey. Sorry, dark grey. Is it dark grey? Very dark grey. Thank you very much, Mr. Delivery Person across the road. One clip. Will be a, let's go for chocolate brown. Chocolate brown. Bit of water. Not too much because we don't know if it'll separate.
And we want to go across here.
Like that, wait for it to dry. Just do our hair. So we need very dark brown. Right. And this is charred brown from Game Color. It looks exactly the same as the chocolate browns but different consistency. Okay. It's a bit redder. Redder? Yeah, it's a bit redder. I've gone for mahogany brown on the bottom of her backpack because it looks like highlighted leather. So just get my little dry brush and just sweep across the top like that. Just to highlight. There. It's the same mahogany brown that we're going to use for the gun stock bit, which I need a clean brush. Just a bit of water. And that is that part there. A bit like that. Okay. Leave that to dry. In a bit. Let's break onto the grey of your vest. So let's zoom in. Back up. There we go. So the grey on our vest is a light grey or neutral grey. So it's one of my favourites, which I'm running out of. Change the top. As I said, I'm running out of this. There we go. And that's a bit of water. And it looks like we picked up a bit of brown with it. But it doesn't matter, because it's just going to be... going to have a wash over the top of it when we're done.
So, if I was to work on highlighted areas, like that, cross it like that.
A bit like that. Right. Let's go back to our light grey again.
Some areas I want to quickly pick off. just a highlight here and there.
So the highlights for the bag are very good friend grey. Highlights for the bags. Okay, so we're gonna got our dry brush and just gonna hit the top like that. It doesn't matter if we can get in there as well. Now the straps for the backpack are not the same. This is a blue grey, dark blue grey, and using a small brush,
and I just want to go across the top there. On that edge there. Like that. Across the top there like that. Highlight that area a bit more, highlight that,
okay, let's go a bit later. I want deck tan. But not that much deck tan. I just want a smidge on the brush and take it off. There a little bit. That's good. Okay, that'll do. So let's finish her hair. Now her hair is ginger. According to the reference photo I've got, it's ginger. And we've got this mahogany broom. And I just want to run this. I just want to run this across the top edge of the brush. I'm going to bring all the colours together now, in a kind of way. I'm just going to give them a bit of a wash with Agrax Earthshade, which I always do, and it gets into all those nice creases. And then we can say that the top part is practically done. It's a very thin wash. I have got another bottle which I top up from, but that's a lot thicker. That light can be a bit darker than that, so I might go put some black over the top. Okay, I'm gonna leave this to dry for the rest of the day. That's me done. And I'll come back and do her jeans tomorrow and her hair. So I've done the gun in 2 lots of grey, 3 lots of grey, dark grey, neutral grey, and in deck tan, because it's not white. We got a bit of express colour, Black Lotus, which isn't black, it's blue, which makes it a nice dark purpley shade. And the school's kicked out and is shouting, and it's ruining my train of thought. Anyway, crack on. A bit of blue on, and then take it off. Leave that to dry, see how it goes. Gun's good. Backpack is good. Backpack needs something. I don't know. There's nothing. Okay, we got this Black Lotus. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drop a bit in there. Is that better? I don't know. We'll have to wait and see till it's, when it's dry. There. Okay, let's just sit and wait. This is our Ellie at the moment, and she's looking really good. I've got a couple of details to go on the back. I've done some purpley blue as a base colour for the jeans to do in this bit, but there are some badges to go on the back. One's golden wings, and the other one is a spaceship. I think there was another one, but not on this model. So, golden wings. Now I got this colour from Scale 75, non-metallic range, and that's Sahara yellow. So I just want to
pick a little bit of detail. Just a little dab.
Okay. The spaceship. We're going to use Goose Grey from Vallejo Game Color Range. And I just want to brush across the top of it. Any parts that's gone over. Like that. Do we need some more? Jeans. As I said, I've done the base colour, and I need a more jean colour. And for this, I'm going to use telescopic or periscope blue. It's like a dirty blue jean colour. Zoom you in a bit. There you go. So I'm just gonna hit across the top. Let's go back here a bit. That's a bit better. Leave this to dry for a little while. Then I come back to it with a lighter colour for a bit. Lighter colour for jeans. But I need to finish off her boots. Okay, this is actually black. There you go. That's actually black. Probably the first time you'll see me use this. I just want to water it down and do a boots because I missed a part yesterday. That one seems to be fine. And I'll leave that to dry for a little bit. I need to go and research details for her. For her shoes. Now, there are white parts to her shoes, I think, and the jeans need to go a little bit lighter, so I'm going to get my dry brush out. And do across the top of her thigh. A bit worn. I'll tell you what, let's do all the creases a little bit lighter. Unfortunate, it's actually taking paint off. So start again. Across the top of there. It's drying very quickly. Okay, I'm going to leave that for a little bit. This is just neat ghost grey. And I just need to see what it's like on top. Whether it's too much, if it is too much smoky noise. Put wash over the top. But we need this too. This area. We also need it to hit this area. A few tabs. Back of the calf. Off a few highlights if you need to, just gently across there and to pocket there, then to like that, then like that. I'm happy with that. This is game colour, Stonewall Grey. And we are using it on our shoes. They need to be white, but they're not white. I just want to go. Cross the front like that. Just across there. Like that. That's a bit bright. Which is okay. Tips. Like that. Leave that to dry for a little bit. This is our good old friend, Agrax Earthshade. And I'm going to use this as a wash over her jeans and everything else, because it's far too clean. Basically, I need a big brush. That's right, lovely. Okay, so from the top, and work down. Okay, let's wash that. I'll leave that to dry for a little bit. Okay. Now the bottom half on our boots. I've got two bottles of Agrax. This is 100%. And it's a lot thicker. Leave that to dry. Now that the washes over her jeans are nice and dry, and we need to look at the base, a bit of colour on there. So we're going to put in some dark rust colour. What else we got? We got some black brown and what else we got? A bit of dark blue grey. Now we're going to mix it up a bit. Dark blue grey. Black brown and dark rust. Which you need to get more of. And I just want to get my dry brush and a lot of water in this. Excuse me, I've just eaten. like that. Clean brush a little bit, grab some water. And this is black brown. And I want this to just sit in areas like that. And do exactly the same with this rusty color. And let that sit for a few minutes. Thanks for watching this little project, guys. It's kept me busy this past week. I've had a terrible time. Thanks for sticking around. The red, you have seen the, there's a short that I've done where it's where it's been finished. The blood is from it's burnt red from AK and other reds from AK. Go and have a look at the short. It's fantastic. Thank you very much. See you on the next build.